Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a scoop neck crop top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this crop top, I'm making inside small, and I also show you how to make this top bigger in this video. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are start making the ribbing panel around the under bust. To begin, make a slip knot. For making the ribbing panels, I'm using 3mm hook and chain 11. If you guys want the ribbing higher, please add more chains. After you got your desired fit, next we are going to make half double crochet. For row 1, skip 2 chains and make half double crochet into the third chain. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make half double crochet but into the back loop of the stitch only. Remember, chain 2 doesn't count as a stitch. Keep making half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you had one last stitch remain, then we are going to make half double crochet into that last stitch. Remember, for the last stitch of the row, we are going to pick the bust loop. And this is what the second row of the ribbing panel looks like. For the next row, keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 68. It is equal 23 inches length. It's the measurement around my under bust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more rows until it fit around your under bust. Then I will meet you back again. this is what the ribbing panel looks like after you reach row 68. Next, we are going to connect the ribbing panels together. To begin, we are going to make slip stitch, continue from where your last stitch is, and continue inside the hook into the other side loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all two loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. For this single crochet row, it's the wrong side of your top. Next, turn the ribbing panel right side out. And this is what it looks like on the right side. For the next part, we are going to make half double crochet around the ribbing panel. I'm still using 3mm hook the same. To begin, for row 1, chain 2 and make half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch to connect the row. Remember, if your first row have 100 stitches, So for your next row must be have the same number of the stitches. Next, for row 2, chain 2. Turn your work and make half the ball crochet into the same stitch with chain 2. Keep making half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. So for this small loop that near chain 2, we doesn't count as a stitch, we are going to skip it, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. For the next row, keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 17. It is equal 5.5 inches length. If you guys want your top longer, please add more rows. And this is what the top looks like after you reach row 17. For the bust part, I'm using 4.5 mm hook. So some few rows around the under bust, I'm using 3 mm hook. And start from row 4, I'm using 4.5 mm hook. It helps the stitch bigger and loose, and it is also help the top stitching when you wearing it. As you can see, the bust part is bigger than the under bust. For the next part, we are going to make the front neckline. To begin, count 20 stitches away from the stitch that you make slip stitch. Then use stitch marker to mark at that 20 stitch. For you guys that make bigger size, please add more stitches. It depends on how you want your neckline more close or wide. In the video, you see that I'm counting only 16 stitches because I want the neckline a little bit close. So I change it to count 20 stitches instead. You guys can follow the pattern that I show on the screen or follow your desired fit. So for this neckline part, I start counting from row 1 again. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. To make half double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and you got 4 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop where we use stitch marker to mark, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have total of 5 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all 5 loops, and this is how we made half double crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make decrease but make half double crochet 2 together. this is how we made half the ball crochet 2 together. Next, keep making half the ball crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches, then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. Remember, for the decreasing stitch, we are going to skip it. Next, keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 6, then I will meet you back again. Please keep decreasing until you got 2.5 inches length. It's the measurement of the top of my shoulder. For you guys that make bigger size, please keep decreasing if you want the strap smaller, or make less decreasing row if you want it bigger. Next, after you got 6 rows of decreasing stitch, for row 7 until row 20, chain 1, turn your work, and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Remember, for the decreasing stitch, we are going to skip it. So start from row 7, we are stop making decreasing stitch. Just make no more half double crochet row. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 20. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the measurement from row 1 until row 20, it is equal 6.5 inches. It is measuring from the underarm to the top of the shoulder. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows. Next, we are going to make the other side strap. Please use stitch marker to mark at this full part. And next, we are going to count the same number like the other side. Count 20 stitches away from the first stitch marker, and then use the second stitch marker to mark at the 20th stitch, and it should look like this. So this is the right side of the row. We are going to turn it and working on the wrong side of the row. To begin, we are going to attach the yarn into the second stitch marker. It is where we are going to make decrease for the neckline. Next, for row 1, chain 1, and make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. Next, continue make half double crochet into every stitch until you reach the first stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. Next, follow 3 chain 1, turn your work and make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. After you have made decrease, then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 6. Then from row 7 until row 20, just make normal half double crochet row without decreasing stitch. After you reach row 20, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what your front neckline looks like. Remember, both sides should have the same number of the stitches and the same number of the row. Next, we are going to make the back neckline. Turn your top and we are going to working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch near stitch marker. For row 1, chain 1 and make half double crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 2 until row 12, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 12. Next, we are going to make decrease for the back neckline by repeat the same thing like the front neckline. To begin, count 20 stitches the same like the front neckline. And count the same number to the other side. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 13 until row 18, we are going to make decrease like we did in the front neckline. After you reach row 18, for row 19 and row 20, just make normal half double crochet without decrease. Remember, for both neckline, should have the same number of the rows and the same number of the stitches. So for my front neckline, I have 20 rows with 10 stitches. So my back neckline must be have 20 rows with 10 stitches the same. Next, we are going to connect these two straps together. Turn your top wrong side out. And we are going to make slip stitch and single crochet both sides together like we did at the ribbon panel. For connecting this strap, you can use the same hook or use smaller hook. After you reach the end of the row, then chain one and cut off the yarn. Don't forget to turn your top to the right side. And this is what it looks like. Next, we are going to make the other strap. Turn your work, like I said, we always working on the wrong side of the stitch, and attach the yarn into the stitch that we mark, and keep decreasing for 6 row, and for row 7 until row 20, just make no more half double crochet row. After you reach row 20, then single crochet both sides together. And this is what the top looks like after you have made the front neckline and the back neckline. Next, we are going to make the sleeve. To begin, attach the yarn into the underarm part. For row 1, chain 1, and we are going to make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Remember, you have to skip some big loops to make the perfect roll, so you don't have like overstitch or looks like ruffle. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 1 stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and skip 1 stitch dead near chain 1 stitch and make half double crochet into the next stitch. Keep making half double crochet into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. So this is your chain 1 stitch and this is your 2 last stitches. Like I said, for the small loop near chain 1, we are going to skip it. After you had 2 last stitches, then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. After you have made decrease, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 1 stitch. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 6. It means that we are going to keep decreasing until you reach the measurement around your upper arm. And this is what the sleeve looks like after you reach row 6. As you can see, the sleeve look more smaller. For my upper arm circumference, it is equal 10.5 inches. After you reach your desired fit, then stop making decreasing row. Just make no more half double crochet row if you want the sleeve longer. Next, for row 7, chain 1, turn your work, skip 1 stitch near chain 1, and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Oh. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 1 stitch. For the next part, we are going to make the ribbing panel around the sleeve. For making the ribbing panel, I'm using 3mm hook. To begin, chain 7. Like I said, if you want your ribbing higher, please add more chains. After you got your desired fit, next, for row 1, skip 2 chains and make half double crochet into the 3rd chain. Keep making half double crochet into every chain until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 5 stitches. For the 2 chains that we skip, it doesn't count as a stitch. Next, we are going to make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch. After you have made a slip stitch, then make another slip stitch into the next 2 stitches. In total, you must have 3 slip stitch stitches. Next, for row 2, turn your work. And we are going to skip 3 stitches that we make slip stitch. Then make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 1 last stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 1 last stitch, then we are going to make half double crochet into that last stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 2, turn your work and make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 and row 3 into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Remember, the number of the stitch in each row must be have the same number. If you have 5 stitches in a row, for the next row must be have 5 stitches the same. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, turn the ribbing panel wrong side out and we are going to make single crochet both sides together. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And now your sleeve is done. Please repeat the same thing to the other side. Remember, make sure both sides have the same number of the stitches so your sleeve don't look like one big and one small. Next, we are going to make single crochet around the neckline as the border. To begin, we are going to attach the yarn into the back part of the top. Next, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch. For this big loop, we are going to skip it. Keep making single crochet around like we did at the sleeve. Some loop you think that you can skip it, go ahead and skip it. Keep making single crochet around until you reach the end of the row. Then we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. After you had made slip stitch, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And this is what your neckline edge looks like. Next, we are going to make the white border around and make the front bow. For the white border, you can use the same hook or use 3mm hook. To begin, make a slip knot and chain 35, it is equal 6 inches. Next, we are going to fold the top into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part. Then continue make single crochet into the next stitch from the stitch marker. Keep making single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then we are going to make 36 chains. After you got 36 chains, then leave a long tail of yarn and cut it off. Pull it a little bit tight to close it. You should have one last stitch left at the middle part. Go ahead and remove the stitch marker and then make a bow. And now your scoop neck crop top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.